Hello and welcome to Forays Tech. I've seen a lot of i3 laptops that come under the $400 mark, and they are put down in a lot of ways. They are considered underperforming and are usually underrated. I, however, have a different point of view. And what that is something we're going to find out in this review of the Acer Aspire E15, E5, 576. Phew, that's a lot of numbers. This is a thick, bulky laptop with a weight of around 5.3 pounds. So if you have mobility and strong built-in mind that can take beating, then this really isn't it. This one has a black, shiny plastic body and the texture isn't that bad, but welcome to a lot of smudges. Also at the back, there's a small panel, which is a good addition that takes just 3 screws to access upgradable internals. So, you can upgrade the supported DDR3L RAM for up to 32 gigs, or you can upgrade from the conventional 1TB hard drive to the M.2 SSD storage. Keep in mind it sports SATA 3 storage only. Now, the keyboard is pure plastic and it's not too noisy, but it's one of the easiest to type on keyboards. The key spacing is adequate and it's just one of those things when you don't have to pay a lot to get a good typing experience. The power button, however, is placed right next to the end, which is not really my ideal placement for a power key. The touchpad is big and it's not noisy, but performance could have been better, so a mouse is probably the best option in this case. On the right, we have the power jack, also have a DVD writer for burning discs if you would want to go old school. Then we have the USB 2.0 port and an audio jack. The left side is more interesting, so we have the USB 3.1 Type-C port, an Ethernet port, the VGA display port, another display port which is the HDMI, a USB 3.0 port, and another USB 3.0 port with power off charging. On the front we also have the SD card reader as well. Now the ports, the DVD, all those connection options are really the reason why this laptop brings so much value as a desktop replacement. So this really is the underdog when it comes to connectivity and port selection. Now the speakers are at the bottom and they sound very average, but the sound is loud enough. Now this is a 15.6 inch screen. It's a bit too oversaturated with not a good contrast and an average brightness, but it is fair for its price. Brightness is sufficient for indoor usage and thankfully not too glossy. Now the color production is okay, and those who are artists and looking for a rather more color accurate screen are recommended to have an external display or a different laptop for that purpose. However, the viewing angles are decent. Thermals are reasonable, the left of the touchpad and the bottom where it gets warm. But it's nothing serious. I mean, at light usage the temperatures remain at a decent 46 to 47 degrees and it peaked at 84 degrees while I was running the multi-core test on Cinebench. About the battery, besides the exaggerated figures presented online that is of 10 hours or so, I got 6 hours on a moderate usage, which is actually impressive for a laptop this price. I've seen more pricier laptops with same specs landing a battery at 3 to 4 hours. With that in mind, a battery between 5 to 6 hours is essentially suitable for most users, so really a thumbs up for that. A quick look at the benchmarks. With these specs, all day-to-day tasks, even with basic editing on Photoshop, I've not felt anything troubling. If this laptop had a SSD with more RAM, this would work out as a brilliant budget option. So fine, you don't have an extremely accurate screen, it doesn't boot up in like 8 seconds, it doesn't have backlit keyboard. So what do you get? You get a good full keyboard and easy upgrade options to get it more faster, more responsive. A lot of battery and lots of connectivity options. You get ports, you get video out, conventional Ethernet, a USB-C, a decent processor with enough RAM, and what you pay is $380 only. I mean, a lot of people compare the i3 with Chromebooks and there is no comparison whatsoever. A Chromebook is built for internet surfing with a different level of productivity and connectivity in mind. So don't get it confused with a laptop which can allow you to install whichever software. It runs slow or fast is a different debate, but it capacitates you to install them and run them even on the lowest settings and get the job done, period. So if you want to buy a laptop, buy AMD's i3, i5, i7 or i9 if you have serious budget. But enough said, enough shown, Do share what you think about my point of view, hit like and subscribe to stay tuned for upcoming reviews. Till again, 4S Tech, signing out.